Hello children, plants are very useful to us. They give us a lot of things such as food, wood, fibers, rubber, gum, medicines, tea, coffee, etc. Life cannot exist without plants. That is why we should grow more and more plants. Do you know that from an average size tree, we can get enough wood to make 170,100 pencils. Now, can you guess what our topic for today is? Yes, you are right. Today's topic is growing plants. Learning objectives. You will be able to discuss the need of reproduction in plants from seeds. Explain the process of germination and its various stages. Identify various parts through which vegetative reproduction takes place. Cite examples for every type of seed dispersal. Discuss the need and significance of seed dispersal. Reproduction in plants. What is reproduction? It is the process by which living beings produce young ones of their own kind. Like all living beings, plants also reproduce. There are few methods of reproduction. First, from seeds. Second, from vegetative propagation. What is vegetative propagation? Vegetative propagation is one way of reproduction in plants. In that, plants reproduce from vegetative parts such as stem, root, and leaves. In this session, we shall learn about growing plants from seeds and dispersal of seeds. Growing plants from seeds. It is very important to know about the seed's structure. The seed coat is an outer covering that protects the baby plant inside. Cotyledons, also known as seed leaves, they are attached together and contain reserve food for the growing plant. Children, you can see in the picture there are two cotyledons. Micropyle is a hole through which seed absorbs water. A small greenish leaf-like appearance is present between the seed leaves. It is called the embryo. This embryo has tiny shoot called plumule and tiny root called radicle. You can see these parts in the given pictures. Let us move on to the germination. It is the process by which a seed produces a new plant under favorable conditions. These favorable conditions are air, water, and temperature. The following are stages of germination. The seed absorbs water from the soil. As a result, the seed coat becomes soft and breaks. The radicle comes out and goes deep into the soil. Then the plumule emerges, which develops and grows towards the sunlight. The seedlings uses the food stored in the cotyledons for its growth. As soon as the new leaves start emerging and start preparing their own food by the process of photosynthesis, then slowly the cotyledons wilt and fall off. You can see the various stages of germination in this picture. To clearly understand this concept, let's watch a video on germination.
Children, you can see in this video the seed coat breaks open and the radical comes out. Then the plumule starts emerging. And from plumule, new leaves arise.
Let us now learn about seed dispersal. Children, have you ever thought that what would happen if these seeds grow close to each other? There will be competition for air, water, sunlight, and nutrients. To avoid overcrowding, nature has provided us some agents that help to scatter the seeds. These agents are known as agents of dispersal. Then what is seed dispersal? It is the process of scattering of seeds by agents of dispersal. What are these agents? They are air, water, animal. Dispersal by wind. Seeds of madar, cotton and dandelion are light in weight and hairy. This helps them to scatter away to far off places with the wind. The seeds of maple and drumstick are also light in weight and winged. Dispersal by water. Plants like coconut, water lily or lotus grow near or in water and have fibrous and spongy outer shell which helps them to float on water. Dispersal by animal. Animals and human beings throw the seeds here and there, and this way seeds get scattered. Seeds of some plants like burdock and xanthium stick to the bodies of animals as they have hooks, thorns, spines or stiff hairs. Dispersal by explosion. Fruits of peas, balsam and lady's finger burst open when dry, scattering the seeds in all directions. Children, now it is time to summarize what we have learned in today's session. We have learned about structure of seeds, the condition necessary for germination, stages of germination, dispersal of seeds and reproduction from seeds. Thank you.